Hybrid heat pumps, what are they? What are their pros and cons? And are they worth switching to? That's what we'll cover in this video. I'm Kata, welcome to Net Zero Tech. Hybrid heat pump simply means that you combine two systems to maximize efficiency. Could be two heat pumps, ground source and air source, or could be a furnace and a heat pump. In this video, we'll focus on combining ground source and air source heat pumps because simply from a financial perspective, using a heat pump system saves a lot of money over the lifetime of the system. I do not recommend adding the baggage of a furnace maintenance and operational cost, let alone comfort, air quality, and the feeling of living a more sustainable life. Combining geothermal heat pumps, GSHPs, with air source heat pumps, ASHPs, can maximize efficiency and cost effectiveness. Well-designed heat pump systems balance upfront cost with low operational cost, resulting in maximum heat pump efficiency, cost effectiveness, and potential for net zero emissions. The market for heat pumps is experiencing strong growth. Recent advances in technology that make heat pumps efficient over a wide range of input and output temperatures have accelerated the market growth. As you likely know, they can be used for both heating, cooling, and in case of air-to-water systems, also for hot water, a desirable feature. There are several types of heat pumps, the two main ones being ground source heat pumps, GSHPs, and air source heat pumps, ASHPs. These heat pumps are usually deployed as a single type or contribution with a fossil fuel heating source. Hybrid heat pumps are those that use both ASHP and GSHP. Air source heat pumps are all electric. All electric heat pump systems for new buildings will soon be the norm, as efficiency, sustainability, and emissions reduction goals are prioritized. This is also true for retrofits in old buildings with heating systems like steam, oil-fired, warm air furnaces, and similar gas-fired equipment. As power from renewables continues to grow market share, and as fully electric systems have the potential to be dominant market leaders in efficiency, the greenhouse gas emission footprint of these buildings will be greatly reduced. Appropriately designed heat pump-driven heating and cooling systems have the efficiency potential to help achieve net zero emission goals. If you've seen some of my other videos on heat pumps, you know that heat pumps move heat from a heat source to a heat sink. For heating applications, the principal energy source, be it subsurface ground or ambient air, is on-site, sustainable, and free. Heat pumps take the freely available thermal energy from the air, ASHPs, and from the ground, GSHPs, and boost it to a higher temperature with a compression expansion cycle. The process is reversed in summer for cooling by taking heat from the inside and expelling it to the air or the ground. Heat pumps are most efficient when the difference in temperature between the source, for instance air or ground, and the output are close. In winter, as the source temperature declines, the system loses efficiency. Likewise, higher output temperatures also lower efficiency. In most inhabited places, the temperature in the ground, 6 feet or 2 meters below the surface, is at least a steady approximately 55 degrees Fahrenheit, so about 12.8 degrees centigrade, year-round. During the heating season, removing thermal energy from the ground reduces the ground temperature around the heat exchanger. It's not unusual for the ground temperature around a geothermal borehole or a horizontal loop to drop from 55 degrees Fahrenheit to below 30 degrees Fahrenheit. The ground temperature gets slowly replenished from moving groundwater, for instance. However, it does not get back up to its starting temperature until after heating season is over. With ground temperatures dropping by 20 degrees Fahrenheit, so about 7 degrees centigrade or more, system efficiency can easily drop by 30% or more. If a standalone GSHP system is being designed for high efficiency, more boreholes are required to keep the system efficient. Boreholes are expensive to drill and fit up, and they can't be located too close together. Also, sizing for 100% of the heat load with GSHPs doesn't always make sense economically, as the heat load only approaches 100% for a matter of hours of days in a year. The answer is to include another heat source to supplement GSHPs. Air source heat pumps make a lot of sense to be that supplement source of energy. Most of the time the buildings need heating, the ambient air temperatures are in the 30s, 40s, and 50s. For instance, in eastern Massachusetts, when the temperature is below 60 degrees Fahrenheit, the air temperature is above 30 Fahrenheit for 77% of the time. When air temperatures are in the 50s, efficiencies between GSHPs and ASHPs are roughly equivalent because the source temperatures are the same. When outdoor temperatures are in the 40s, the GSHPs have a marginal efficiency advantage over ASHPs. The difference in efficiency becomes more significant when temperatures drop to the 30s and below. Most of the heating season, air temperatures are above 30 degrees Fahrenheit. So the key objective of running a heating system is optimized seasonal efficiency rather than moment-to-moment efficiency, there is good reason to continue to use ASHPs at these above 30 Fahrenheit temperatures. By only using GSHPs sparingly at these relatively mild temperatures, in-ground temperature remains in the 50s, so that the GSHPs can be used very efficiently when air temperatures are frigid. The key to implementing an efficient and cost-effective heat pump installation is with thorough technical and financial planning up front. A good plan should encompass expected energy use and cost analysis and include monitoring and performance benchmarking over time. Upfront costs for GSHPs is much higher than for ASHPs. And ASHPs are just as efficient for parts of the year. So the plan needs to identify the right balance of cost and benefits. A feasibility study and design analysis is the best way to approach this problem. The analysis should include a site evaluation, a building evaluation, and a parametric analysis of data related to upfront cost, hardware efficiency estimates, and operating cost. A full design plan should also include system control recommendations for balancing the operation of the hybrid system. To truly optimize the system performance, tracking and benchmarking must be included. Every site is different, so ground source heat pumps will not operate exactly the same at different sites. System performance data matched with weather data, time of day, and time of season data will help to fine-tune the system optimization. Thank you so much for watching. Don't forget to subscribe. I very much appreciate if you consider supporting me on Patreon, linked below. Have a great time and see you in the next one.